preseason, but another comeback. It's on that team that's used to from last season. But what was it like to have the team stay engaged as you guys fell down 10 in that fourth quarter and come back in the end?
I thought my guys stayed engaged. You know, kind of hard, playing around the point guard. We stayed both bridges and that stuff. But I thought that first quarter, we did some good things, play with pace. And then our young guys, they came in, like I said, down the stretch towards the end of that third quarter and kind of got things going. Moving out the basketball, good cuts, good passes. In the second half, we finally started going to advanced passes and attacking early. It's opened up the shots on. So we just have to continue to keep getting these two and continue to keep building our habits.
Team gave up a lot of fast break points. I know last week in camp you said that was an area where you wanted to make sure to button that up. How does the team do that, or is that something you got to look at the tape and figure that out from there?
No, we just got to get back and raise the shot. We got a lot of crashing, a lot of ball stabbing in the backcourt, and we're going to get matched up in transition. And, a lot of times our team to play a small, it's hard for our teams to get matched, but we just got to do a better job. When the shot goes up, one, two, or three, have to get back. So.
Coach, what are some of your immediate takeaways, especially as you look at some of the younger talent?
To stay the course. I thought Brandon Boston was a good guy. I love Kyle Trump at night. I thought Facebook did some good things. I thought Amir Coffee did some great things. So just continue to keep building that. Continue trying to, work on the fans, pass attack, really, if you don't have a small pick. Slipping out of it, continue to keep playing. I thought we got stagnant a lot tonight. We continue to move the ball, continue to move by that we're really changing. So just continue growing that aspect of just working on what we're trying to do fundamentally offensively and kind of grow from it.
You discussed pregame about wanting to see what Isaiah, Harry, and Brandon do defensively in particular. What your evaluations of those three guys on that side?
We know Brandon can foul, but he competes though. He plays hard and he tries. So that's all you can ask. We just continue working on technique with him, fundamental styles, fundamental things of playing defense. But he gives you a half break single night. You can live with that. I thought, Harry and Isaiah did a decent job. I got him to take. We have him switching a couple times. We have him forward a couple times as well. Because of the shooting they have for Jeffrey and Jermichael and they had Gordon. So, it was a tough game to play. It's a tough guy. Tough game for our players to actually, try to judge those guys on the best one. So, we'll look at the tape. We'll continue to get better. And I'll go from there.
It's a two-parter on Terrence. How much did you want to put the ball in his hands in the fourth quarter? As you said, didn't really point guard out there. How much did you want to see what he could do as a point guard in that
position? Just see if he can make plays for himself, for his teammates. He is one of the best guys on the floor at the top. Understand, we run basic stuff because about point guards. It's hard to tell if guys come out and plays and sets, but I thought he did a good job. I thought he got fouled a couple times that he didn't get. But for the most part, I thought the defense got some stops down the stretch and was able to get a fast pass attack. I thought he did a good job of catching that one dunk. Just continue to keep playing. I thought Luke, early on, missed some shots. Kind of, he wasn't a good rhythm. Downstretch and make some big shots as well. So, T-Man, like I said, they'll keep growing, they'll keep getting better. And we just like to get him on the floor, he's going to make things happen.
Brandon said post game that T-Man's been in his ear, but he's also one of the young guys that's on the best of his ear. So, how does that dynamic work with Terrence being both sort of a veteran and still the young guy that learns from the older guys?
I think just, John teaching what we stand for here, the Clippers, how he got his opportunity last year to get second in the league and was able to grow. I don't really coach mistakes. You play hard and play the right way. The mistakes are going to happen. So just a lot of fights, those mistakes, not to get better. Just play the right way.
George King, Moses Wright, those guys, they got in the game and they look really good. They look ready. And we haven't really discussed those guys since camp started. What have you seen from those guys over the course of camp? And, what's really the next step for those guys?
George King's like a veteran. I don't know how old he is or whatever, but he comes to the gym every morning. He's there at 7 o'clock, working on his game, working on his body. He's one of the guys that kick up the floor every day. He's always working. He's loved to see it from a young guy. He has a Dom, you know, I'm thinking on full court, like step on the court, think on Monty Moore's full court, one guard slot, and just how he competes defensively. I mean, it just says a lot about him. And, you know, Moses, I just think his athletic ability, his ability to make shots, his ability to block shots on the rim, and the finish around the basket. I mean, really gives him a huge momentum boost when he came in the game. Bobo blocked the shot the first time, and then he attacked some authority on the finish at the rim. So he did a great job as well. So my young guy, like I said, coming around, we can't really wait. That's why I continue to ask up offensively. So it's got to help, you know. But for the most part, I think it's shot.
What do you tell a guy that's a teacher? I mean, is that just like to be expected from the start? Yeah, I mean, like I said, he competes, you know, he plays hard, you know, he don't get fouls, time, but he's had a lot of out, you know, pick and choose when to be aggressive, when not to be aggressive. If you have two fouls, you can't get the third foul, you know, in that first half. So just, you know, learn experience from him and stuff, but like I said, I don't, I don't, you know, knock his
Knock is competitive nature, better acquired. He competes every single time he's going on the basketball. Like at the end of the game, right there, you got a huge stop for us. You know, guard a point guard, you know, sit down, get a good test without fouls. So it's that.
Hey, Tony, you mentioned that you want to see the team play well without the basketball. So how would you evaluate the movement, you know, off the ball with cutters and everything tonight?
I thought we did the same thing a lot, you know, just I thought we did a lot of the same cuts, not really mixing it up. They kind of locked into the principles. Our bigs, you know, they took back the pass a lot, got a lot of questions, slowing down, just the questions as well. So the looks were there, a couple we missed, but we just got to keep working at it. You know, and this is a good team to play. They have great defensive principles. You know, tough team to play. So we gave a lot of things about ourselves, just continue to move forward and get better.
Thanks, Coach. Appreciate it.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.